Would you please educate me? How did we violate the principle of separation of powers?
For the record, it says, the principle of separation of powers is violated when one branch of government unduly encroaches in the domain of another. Jurisprudence provides that there are only two ways to violate the subject principle, namely, by impermissible interference with another department's performance and by assumption of another department's functions. Here, it is clear that the subpoena was not issued in aid of legislation and thus exceeds the legislative power of inquiry, and its issuance impermissibly interferes with the exclusive functions of the Commission on Audit and infringes upon the independence of the Commission. And then, first, Congress has no power to participate or otherwise take part in any audit process. Obtaining any information in a pending audit clearly does not serve a legislative purpose of drafting or remedying legislation. Second, the audit decisions which the committee seeks to obtain are in cases still pending adjudication, and therefore not final, not conclusive, and cannot be used as a fair, accurate, or intelligent basis for legislation. Third, COA has already published its annual audit reports for fiscal year 2022 and 2023, which are specifically intended to aid the executive and legislative departments in crafting responsive laws and regulations. Fourth, the only purpose mentioned is to expose to the public the use of confidential funds by the offices headed by the Vice President and purportedly whether such use follow the guidelines. During the subject hearing, Representative Castro stated, since hindi po pwedeng sabihin dito yung findings, yung report o yung anumang observations ng COA, ang mga taong bayan po interesado dito sa confidential funds at kung paano ito ginamit, kung ito po ba ay sumunod dun sa guidelines. Also, as reported in the media, Representative Castro has been known to say that the Vice President has not yet satisfactorily explained the OVP spending of confidential funds in 2022. She added that the VP still has yet to account how she spent the said funds in 2023 and that she is not off the hook yet, end of quote. This is not related to any legislative purpose. There is no congressional power to expose for the sake of exposure. The determination of whether the utilization of the funds complied with audit guidelines falls within the exclusive mandate of the Commission on Audit. It cannot be overemphasized that COA has the exclusive power, authority, and duty to examine, audit, and settle all accounts pertaining to the revenue and receipts of and expenditures or uses of funds and property. Constitutional framers envisioned the COA as a dynamic, effective, efficient, and independent watchdog of the government, and for this reason, conferred upon it broad and extensive powers, allowing a committee of the House of Representatives to subpoena audit decisions pertaining to an ongoing audit will only hamper the COA's performance of its duties. On the other hand, the determination as to the legality of confidential funds solely falls within the exclusive mandate of the judiciary. Clearly, therefore, Congress cannot infringe upon constitutional mandates vested upon other branches of the government.